Hello everyone, Ranjita here. Welcome back to my channel. Now, in this pandemic, all of us are running short of craft supplies. Well, how about having some crafty fun with things that we already have? So here I am with some easy craft inspiration. Today, I am here to show you some easy ways on how to make simple gift tags. I love making tags and bookmarks. They are very, very quick and easy projects, but they also make wonderful gift options as well. So today, let's make some gift tags using coffee paint. Interesting, isn't it? It is very easy and very quick version of using your own paint. So without any delay, let's get started. For this project, I have a little helper with me. In fact, I am the helper and she is the one who completes all these four tags. Wouldn't believe, isn't it? So you have to check out the entire video to see how my 5-year-old daughter makes these four beautiful tags using coffee paint. So first here, I have cut out an A4 sized watercolor paper. So my daughter is cutting them into four pieces. So we will be making four tags today using coffee paint. So I have four pieces of paper here. All we are going to do is we are going to make different patterns on these four pieces. For this, we are taking some coffee powder, and into this coffee powder, my little daughter is mixing some water here. Make sure you do not add too much water at once, because the more watery your mixture is, the more lighter the color you get. You will get a hang of it when you start experimenting with different shades. So, like I said, first start with very little water. We are also having some tissue here handy so that we can dab off any excess splatters. For the first pattern, my little daughter has taken an old toothbrush and she's dipping the toothbrush into the mixture that we have made, or the coffee paint that we have made, and she's randomly making splatters all over the paper. It really looks messy here, but trust me, it's going to turn out very, very beautiful at the end. By the way, this is definitely going to be a messy job, so make sure you protect your work surface well. So here we have a polythene sheet, and over it we have put the paper onto which we are planning our pattern. The second piece of paper, my daughter has dipped in a simple fork that every kitchen has, and she's just randomly making patterns all over the paper. A simple fork, it makes such beautiful patterns, and the kids will love getting messy and making their own patterns on this. In case if you feel that there is a lot of coffee on your paper, you can dab it off with a tissue, or you can continue to work on it as well. But when you dab it, you have a lighter shade here and it entirely creates a different pattern altogether. So feel free to experiment with different items that are lying around and make different patterns of your own. You will end up making a unique pattern every time, even if you use the same item to make a pattern. For this project especially, I didn't want to have any fancy items while crafting, because I wanted to have some inspiration for even non-crafters as well. So I'm sure many of you would not be having much fancy supplies. So even if you are a non-crafter and you want to make something beautiful, this would be a definite inspiration for you. And for the third tag, or the third paper here, my daughter is dipping her sharpener and she's making random impressions of the sharpener all over the page. This would be very, very interesting for kids as well, because they're going to love messing up their hands first of all, and they will also start hunting around things with which they can make different types of patterns and different impressions on their paper. And coffee is something every household would definitely have. So make sure you try out your impressions with the different items you find around your craft room or around your house. She's also adding some more splatters with her toothbrush to add some more interest onto this. For the last one, we have taken a sponge dauber. You can take a piece of cloth or you can take a bubble wrap or anything that is handy to make such impressions. First, she's dipping the sponge dauber into the paint, and then she's dabbing off the excess on the tissue and then lightly making impressions of the sponge all over the paper. As you can see, the table is entirely messy right now, but make sure that you protect your table while doing this. But it's going to turn out very, very beautiful at the end, trust me. So here are the four patterns that we have made. The first one with toothbrush splatters, the second one with the fork, the third one with a sponge dauber, and the last one we made using impressions with a sharpener. Make sure your paint dries well before you go on to the next step. So here is a sheet of digital images that I have printed out for her to color. These designs are from Doodle Daisies and Ink. I have been their DT inspiration this month, and I have printed down these on a watercolor cardstock, and now my little daughter is going ahead and painting them. Well, she's coloring these images also with the coffee paint that we have made. I have given her a water brush, so all she has to do is just dip in the brush into the paint, and occasionally she will be squeezing some water in case if she would like to dilute the paint. Many a times I've been asked by many friends, people who follow me on my social media, they keep asking me that these supplies are not easily available, or we do not have all these fancy supplies with us. Can you show us a simpler version of it and all? Well, this is my 5-year-old daughter here painting with this coffee paint, and if my 5-year-old daughter can do it, then definitely any non-crafter can do it. And I'm sure the paper that I have been using, or the coffee and some old book pages, these are all you need to complete this project, and I'm sure you will have these at every household. So first she's giving a light coat of this coffee paint all around the images. And then I will be adding some finer details onto it. Because she was too small to add these details, I took over and I added the finer details. But here she is painting these coffee mugs completely by herself. If you haven't painted with coffee before, I think you should definitely give it a try. It is a very interesting medium. You get a very good monochromatic look to your projects. You can have lighter as well as darker shades with the same paint. So here I am adding some shadows and highlights to the project. So my daughter has first made a thin layer of lighter shade of brown here, and then I'm going over it with the same water brush, adding some darker shades here and there depending on the light source. Just a little coffee powder and some water, that is all you need to color these digital images and make them look real. So I'm going to go ahead and finish coloring the other two coffee mugs as well. This is the same process that I will be following. So these are my completely colored, dried and fussy cut images. And here are the patterns that we have done. They are completely sun dried as well. Make sure your pattern papers are completely dried before you move ahead to the next step. Otherwise they might look tacky. And here we are making them into tags using an envelope punch board. Very easy way of making tags in case if you do not have any fancy dies or any other equipment to cut your tags. If you do not have an envelope punch board also, what you can do is just round out the corners and just make them turn into tags. Or if you can wish to leave them just the way they are, they look beautiful that way as well. We will be doing this on all the other tags also. So here is our finished tag, and we will be doing the same thing with the other tags as well. So here I am taking an old book page here. If you do not have a stained old book page, you can stain it yourself. I will come up with another video where you can stain your own paper and make it look very vintagey and old. or else you can have an old newspaper in case if you do not have such old book pages, or you can completely skip this step, or you can even try out some brown paper from your kids, the paper that you use to cover your kids' books as well. So here my daughter is ripping these papers into smaller pieces as random as possible. There is no right way or wrong way of doing it. Just rip them into thin long pieces. We are just going to use them to add some more interest to our bookmarks. So my daughter is enjoying because she loves tearing paper, especially if it's with her hands. She would love to use the scissors sometimes, but this ripping, she had a lot of fun. So here she is tearing down the paper into smaller pieces. That's it. We are done with all the elements. Now we are going to assemble them with a simple glue. So we are taking some glue here and we are assembling our tags. She is just randomly sticking these pieces of the torn page here, just to add some interest to our bookmark. You can totally skip this step, but I insist you do this because it's going to add a lot of interest to your tags and it's going to take it to another level. So here we are just adhering random pieces of the paper here. We're doing it with all the four tags. While crafting with kids, make sure your designs are very simple and also you use very less raw material. Because the more material you use and the more complicated the design gets, children tend to lose interest and they would not like to craft anymore. So make sure you keep your designs easy and simple. So here we are just adhering these tiny bits of paper here and there randomly all over the tag. This is adding so much more interest to the tag. Now we have put some double-sided adhesive on the images, digital images that we have colored, and my daughter is peeling off the double-sided adhesive and she's randomly placing it on the tag. We haven't put any quotation or any sentiment on the tag because we wanted to keep it that way and we wanted to write or stamp a sentiment according to the occasion on which we will be using these tags. So I prefer to make such generic tags and bookmarks every now and then and keep it in stock so that when some birthday comes suddenly we can give them. So here are our finished tags that my little daughter managed to complete them. They turned out very, very beautiful. They were quick to make, easy to make, very, very easy and readily available items lying around your house. That is all you need. Some old book pages, coffee, a little water, and some random digital images that you can download it from the internet. These were all you need to complete these tags. I hope you like them. You can see the close-up images of the finished project here. I really liked how beautifully they turned out. With very, very limited supplies and very easily available, readily available supplies lying around your house, my little daughter made these beautiful tags. I am so proud how they turned out. In case if you are inspired by this video and you would like to make something similar, make sure you share it with me on my social media. The links are given in the description box below. Thank you so much for stopping by. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also follow me on my social media. The links are given in the description box below. Thank you.